Award-winning DJ Scott Fajolik has provided interactive DJ, MC, and trivia game show entertainment for a variety of events since 1988. In addition to serving as the owner of First Class DJ, DJ Scott Fajolik is the director of the Wedding and Event Network, a collection of the best businesses in the wedding and event industry located in the greater Puget Sound area. Dedicated to helping grow businesses and the event industry, members of the Wedding and Event Network gather to discuss, share clients, and even meet with potential clients. Here today to host the Women Today Wedding Talk Show, please join us in welcoming to the stage DJ Scott Fajolik.
Welcome to our wedding talk show. First, I'd like to introduce our talk show guests for today. They are all leaders in the wedding industry and are the best in what they do. First, we have Lynann White. Lynann owns American Rose Bridal in Paulsbo. She and her staff have helped thousands of women, men, and children in the Kitsap area find the perfect garment for their special occasion, no matter what their size, age, or budget. Again, a round of applause for Lynann White. Second with us today, we have Elaine Terso, known for her artistic visions. Elaine Terso Photography describes their style as a combination of candid photojournalism with a creative edge. And third, we have Gina Teresi, who is an independent beauty consultant from Mary Kay. She enjoys sharing her knowledge of skincare and personalized glamour while building lasting friendships with her customers. Her business allows her to pamper women of all aspects, from the stay-at-home mom to the beautiful bride. Again, a round of applause for our wonderful Gina Teresi. And last but definitely not least, we have Brandine Baumgartner, who is a part of the team of planners with Diligent Details Event and Wedding Planning. Brandine is known for her unique and creative skills. Round of applause for Brandine. So I'm going to start our wedding talk show here with some questions for Lynann White. Lynann, first off, what are the colors that are the current in colors for weddings this year?
There's a lot of bright colors, bright reds and oranges and corals, and also blues are popular. A lot of blues, and the blues tend to blend together, so you can have several shades of blue in your wedding and everything blends together. You know, can't do that as much with reds because, some reds can clash, but the blues are very popular too.
How about bright green? That's my color.
I haven't seen too much of that.
Okay. I heard that you need to shop for a wedding gown a year before the wedding. Is that true?
Well, if the sooner you can start shopping, the more you will have to choose from. Some dresses do take 6 months to order, so if you have more time, you'll have more choices. You can just walk in a bridal shop, well, at least you can, like an American Rose Bridal, just walk in the shop and purchase a dress off the rack. Mm-hmm. There's quite a few in there. I had one bride that came in the day before her wedding.
Oh, my.
She came in on a Wednesday evening. She was getting married Thursday, and Thursday's the day we're closed.
Oh,
so
wow.
We had to come back, do her alterations that night, and come back and meet her the next day. So we can't do last-minute weddings. But the more time you have, the more you have to choose from. You can go through the racks, and if there's something you want to order, then you'll have time to order.
Yeah. That reminds me of a story. I was meeting with a bride and groom, and I was talking to them and asked them how long they've been engaged, and they said 3 days. And I'm like, wow, you guys are really getting going on your wedding plans and hiring services and stuff. And then later in the conversation, I asked them, how long have you known each other? And they said 5 days. And I'm like, no, seriously, how long have you guys known each other? And they said 5 days. And I'm like, so after 2 days, you got engaged. So a week ago, you did not know each other exists. And they're like, no, it was love at first sight, and we knew we were the ones. And
what should someone know about trying on a wedding gown for the first time?
Well, if you've not been shopping for a wedding gown or formal wear before, you need to know that most of it's European sizing, and so they're going to run smaller. 1 to 2 sizes smaller, so if you're normally a size 12, don't be surprised if you're wearing size 14 and 16 in formal wear. So, try not to think about the number, because nobody else is going to know what size the dress is.
Yeah.
So think of that just as a number.
That's good advice. I'm a size 12, so I probably want to do the 14.
When you go in, it's a good idea to have a strapless bra, because most of the gowns are strapless, and it looks better, when you come out of the dressing room with a nice, pretty white strapless gown on if you don't have the purple bra straps coming out.
Yeah.
And you can borrow one from the shop if you need to, but it's a good idea if you have your own. When you come shopping, I would suggest only bringing maybe two people with you. I know there's a few TV shows that, you know, like Say Yes to the Dress, and there's people up there, and they bring their whole family, and I think they just want to be on TV, because it's really not a good idea. You get too many opinions in there, and it just makes it more difficult. It's easier if you just bring somebody like your mother and maybe a best friend that you can trust their judgment.
Yeah, sounds good. What have you found are some of the wedding trends this year?
There's a lot more outdoor weddings. Mm. I hear a lot more people getting married outdoors. Shoes are really interesting. It used to be your shoes were either white or ivory, and now they're every color. They're blingy, like, you know, those pretty shoes there, or bright colors, fuchsia shoes, red shoes, and there's been a lot of Converse.
Oh.
You know, tennis shoes.
I've actually seen
anything,
that at a wedding.
Anything goes for shoes now. And then another thing that's coming up and becoming popular are brooch bouquets. And instead of, you know, having a floral bouquet that, you know, will wilt or you have to have dried afterwards, it's filled with jewelry and brooches, and you can keep it afterwards as a keepsake. And those are becoming more popular.
I've seen bride and groom come in with cowboy boots. So.
Yep, I've seen those too.
Flip-flops.
Oh, wow.
A lot of flip-flops at the reception. Change flip-flops later.
What are some other things, Lynanne, besides the price of a gown that a bride should consider when looking for either a wedding gown or gowns for her attendants?
Well, you want to take into consideration body type. Bridesmaids really like it if they can use the gown again. So if it's something, you know, that doesn't look like it's just for a wedding. A lot of short dresses are popular, maybe knee-length dress, and that's something that they can wear again afterwards.
What should a bride do with their gown after the wedding? Any advice for the brides?
They need to make a decision whether they'd like to keep it or not. I like to keep it. I have my grandmother's wedding gown, and I have my mother's wedding gown, and my wedding gown, and I think that's really neat.
Oh, yeah.
But some people, they just don't want to use up the closet space or whatever, and they, you know. If you do want to keep it, you should have it cleaned and preserved. Mm-hmm. I suggest going to a reputable cleaning company, not just any local dry cleaner. You really want a reputable company that you can go through and make sure that it's stored properly if you do want to hold on to it. If you don't want to hold on to it, there are places you can do consignment. So you can do consignment and sell your gown if you need to.
So stuffing it in a box and putting it in the attic, that's probably a no-go.
No, that's not a good idea. Yeah. I had a bride one time that came in, and she had her gown that had been in, well, I don't know if you consider a bride after 25 years. She had her gown in the attic for 25 years and then brought it in to be cleaned, but it did end up looking really wonderful.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Lynanne. I wanted to add on to a couple things that Lynanne talked about. First of all, with your shoes, I was told a really good advice is to break in your shoes before the wedding day so you don't get those sore feet on your wedding day. And also scuff up the bottoms on cement or your driveway so they're not slippery. Some people think that couples need to pick just one or two colors. I think you touched on this too. And then base their whole wedding off of that, off of those colors. Kind of the new trend is incorporate many colors. So I even seen a wedding where they had a rainbow of colors for the bridesmaids. It looked really cool. And they also tie in the flowers, decorations, groom's ties. So kind of going off of the traditional. So thank you very much, Lynanne. Next, I want to move on to our ever-enthusiastic Elaine Turso. I got a few questions for you, Elaine. What would you say is the biggest mistake that people make when shopping for a photographer?
So I would say one of the biggest mistakes that brides and grooms make is shopping on price alone. That always seems to be the number one question that people ask is, I get an email, how much do you charge? And they don't know me, they don't know if we're going to be a good fit, and I would say that they should be doing an in-person interview with their photographer and actually interview the photographer to make sure that they're going to be a good fit, because you don't want somebody showing up to your wedding that you've never met and then have a complete clash of personality, because you're going to be really unhappy on your wedding day.
Yeah.
Do you really want somebody in your dressing room? Do you want this person in your dressing room? Think about that. And so
that's a tough question. It's kind of like going into a car dealership and saying, how much is a car?
I mean,
there's, you know, there's
a lot
of different...
You don't know the amenities. Right. You don't know what the benefits are, what the features are.
Right.
You have to test drive it a little bit, make sure that it's going to work for you.
Make sure you feel comfortable with your wedding services.
Yes, absolutely.
Definitely. What are some tips that you could give to brides and grooms who are looking for a wedding photographer?
I would say meet in a neutral place. So maybe a coffee shop, or a lot of my brides and grooms come to my studio, or I go to their house and I show them samples and we talk about their day, what they want, what they vision. And we just talk about all the options because there are so many. Every bride and groom is unique. And so I kind of cater all of my photography to them specifically. Yeah. So they're not put in a cookie cutter box that this is what you have to have.
Yeah.
So they can have whatever they want.
Definitely. Yeah. Feeling comfortable with your wedding service is so very important. I treat my customers and clients as if they were friends. What would you say is your favorite moment during a wedding?
I absolutely love it when a bride and groom will agree to do a first look. And that is when they get to see each other before the ceremony. And it's just the two of them having a very private, special moment between each other and me. And I get to be there to capture it all on film. And they, it kind of takes that stress, that like we did it, and now they're not so nervous walking down the aisle. It's kind of a big sigh of relief. They get to see each other, the anticipation, and it just makes it having that really special moment and doing it before all your guests get there. It also makes a great opportunity to get all of your additional formal pictures done before your guests arrive, because a lot of times what I see happen is that they have their ceremony, and then they go start doing their pictures, and the guests are sitting around waiting for an hour until the reception can start. So I try and recommend, please do that in advance, because that way it's gonna, your guests are not going to be sitting around waiting for you to get there to enjoy the party.
Yeah. I like those wedding illusion pictures that I've seen, where my wife and I did it at our wedding, where she held her hand out, and then I stood far in a distance, and it looked like she was holding me in the palm of her hand. So those are a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Elaine, one more question. What would you say is your most popular product that brides and grooms purchase to remember their special day?
I am a big fan of the photo book, and I have various different styles of photo books. I have ones that are small and petite that are really great to give to moms and dads and grandparents to kind of commemorate the day. And then I have really elaborate, elegant books that are made in Italy that are just drop-dead gorgeous. Yeah. So, and it's kind of the scrapbooker in me, which is I kind of like to tell it as a story, so it has a beginning and an end, and I'm really anal about it. I have to go in order. I cannot have my pictures go out of order. It's not how it happened. It's not how the story happened.
Yeah.
So I'm really worried about that, but that's just how I do things. So, but the photo books are really popular, and I make these little ones too that are fit right in your purse. And you know, when you go to, when you give one to your mom or something, and they go to church or to the grocery store, oh, you want to see my baby? And which are really great for newborns too. Hint, hint. By the way.
Yeah, those are great gifts to give away to like parents and grandparents.
Absolutely, and that's something that they'll have forever. So.
Yeah, definitely. Thank you so much, Elaine.
Thank you.
A few tips that I thought of. First off, have your wedding photographer take a picture of your reception room before everyone arrives. That's photo really booths nice. Or flip books are very fun.
You're planning on
having disposable cameras at your wedding, even though I'm not a big fan of those. If you have to have them out, or if your parents purchased them and said, here, use these, giving every table a task with their disposable camera. For instance, table number 7 is in charge of the cake cutting with their disposable camera, or table number 3 is in charge of the bouquet toss with their disposable camera. So, because otherwise those pictures end up not working, don't look good. And next, I have some questions for our magnificent makeup artist, Gina Teresi from Mary Kay. First of all, brides, if you or one of your bridesmaids are planning on doing your own makeup at your wedding day, make sure to definitely first get some very helpful instructions from a makeup professional like our very own Gina, a makeup professional that can help instruct you to accentuate certain facial features, minimize less flattering features, recommend a color palette that best complements your skin tone. So, Gina, I have a couple questions for you. First, can you tell us more about what brides can do in preparation for their big wedding day?
Okay, what a lot of brides think of is just to, you know,
put on makeup. Mm. What you really need to do ahead of time, at least a month in advance, is have a really great skin regimen. Mm. You need a good moisturizer, a good cleanser, and you need to do that morning and night so that your skin is beautiful and glowing and not just you're not just covering with makeup. It'll bring out your beauty instead of cover and kind of make you look too overdone.
Yeah. Gina, do you have any advice to make my forehead less shiny?
Well, we have some highlighting pens and some bronzers that can kind of fake it.
Got it. Gina, can you also give us some tips to prepare for the photographs that a photographer like our wonderful Elaine Terso will be taking of the brides?
It's really important to meet with me ahead of time, to really not stick to those trends, because when you look back 10 years, into your photos, you really don't want to see, the bright blue eyeshadow that was used to be popular, yeah. or any of those trends. So you really want to have gorgeous, subtle, neutral colors that are going to enhance your beauty. Mm. Also, you want to stick to more matte foundation, something that's going to blend with your skin. You need to really have a great foundation. You can use concealer to hide any imperfections and a loose powder to take away any of that oiliness or shininess, because that will really show up in the photographs.
Has a bright green eyeshadow, has that taken off yet?
Not so much.
No, okay. Thank you so much, Gina. Now we have some questions for our brilliant event planner, Brandine Baumgartner. First off, Brandine, you are considered as part of a team with Diligent Details. So what exactly does that mean, part of a team?
Well, the owner, Donna, she's the owner and founder. Her vision for the company is to have a bridal consultant for any type of bride, no matter the personality or style. So we are there to help you no matter what kind of style or personality you have. We're here to fit and help you as much as possible.
Very good. What would you say are the hot trends here in 2012, 2013 weddings?
The most popular one we're seeing right now is the rustic farm look. And we're in a fantastic area for it because there's tons of old farmhouses and country houses turning into venues, and it really can bring out the style of the bride and everything like that. But also some other trends are doing little things to do your own personality, like the bling bride. Mm. You can do paperweights as favors and putting your information on it, and it's like big diamonds, and it's useful, and
nice.
So it's really nice. Or the dog lovers who want their animals or their little totos involved in their wedding, but you also have to check with your venue to make sure it's pet friendly.
Yeah.
So we had a bride last year who loved Michael Jackson. The couple was obsessed. So what they did is each table had a song, and when the Michael Jackson song got to play, they got to go up and go to the buffet to eat.
Wow.
And so the DJ joked, like, if you don't know the song, you might starve.
Yeah. Very cool. You're a military bride. Do you have any suggestions for our other military brides watching the show today?
Well, yes. We got married very fast, and we had a simple civil ceremony because he was going to be shipped off soon. Is there any other military brides out there? No? Okay. Well,
got a couple.
Stay true to yourself. Like, you have a vision at first, and I know people want their family and friends, their advice and what they want involved, but you should really stay true to what you want, and it's about you and your husband to be. It's about your love and how to show that.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Very good. Thank you very much, Brandine. Next is my turn. I've done well over 1,000 weddings in the past 20 years. I could write a book on all the tips of things that I've seen that work and don't work. First off, a story. I was doing a wedding, and it was around cocktail hour, right at the beginning of cocktail hour. I heard the bride scream my name, and I'm like, oh my gosh, what happened? And so I ran to the back room. As I'm running to the back room, I see this red light that's shining on her dress, and I'm looking up in the ceiling. I'm trying to figure out where that red light is coming from. I'm getting closer and closer, and it was red wine all down her wedding dress. And I'm like, oh my gosh. And She said, Scott, my lovely husband, decided to give me a hug and forgot that he had a glass of red wine in his hands. And she's like, you've been to a lot of weddings. Help. So I said, okay, club soda, Pat with club soda. So we had all the waitresses come by, start patting, club soda, and I could not believe how well the club soda worked with the patting. It was like all gone at the end of the cocktail hour. No one even knew what had happened. So we were just so excited about that. Then there's the stories where I did a wedding and it was out on a pier. We had the bride, the groom, the best man, maid of honor, and the person that was marrying them. They were out in the at the end of the pier, and they said, at this time, we need the best man to give us the rings, and ding, ding, splash, right into the water, the wedding rings. And there was complete silence for a very long minute. We did not know what to do. Someone jumping in the water and getting the rings. So then he pulls out the real rings out of his pocket, and he hands it to them, and the bride was not very happy with the best man. I'm going to go through some rapid-fire wedding tips. I've got a ton of wedding tips. I'm going to try and get through as many of these as I can to give to you guys. First of all, kind of pre-wedding tips. We're going to start with organization. Consider setting up a separate wedding email address, a separate wedding checking account, even a wedding website to post everything that you need to communicate to your guests and your vendors. That works very well. Consider choosing a wedding theme. This will help your wedding to not look like a cookie-cutter wedding, like they were saying. Some themes may include having each reception table representing a favorite movie of yours. Then you can design the tables like that. Or a favorite vacation spot, or a favorite memory of yours. You can have every table designated to a favorite memory of yours. Also, I heard brides bring wedding emergency kits. Have you guys seen the wedding emergency kits? Oh, very good. I'm going to read off some things that should be in a wedding emergency kit, and then I'm going to open it up to our ladies here to see if they have any other ideas. Needles, mini scissors, thread in the color of your dress and your bridesmaids' dresses, extra lipstick, safety pins. The lipstick's not for the guy, it's for the lady. Safety pins, dental floss, chapstick, clear nail polish, Band-Aids, Advil, Kleenex, hairspray, bottled water, crazy glue, toothpicks. Those are a couple of mine. Anyone would like to add to that?
Deodorant.
Deodorant.
Just saying.
Yep.
If you have a straw in there, you won't mess up your lipstick if you want to take a drink.
Good advice. Yeah, I always mess up my lipstick.
And I always like a little bit of chocolate in there, but just the bite-sized kind, so you can just pop it in your mouth and not get it all over the place.
Did you say clear nail polish?
Clear nail polish.
Yeah, that's going to help with the runs in the nylon.
Yeah, very good.
I despise nylons. also, another good trick for lipstick is to use your liner all over your lips and then put the lipstick over and then to do a dab of lip gloss. So in your a little emergency kit, you're going to want to keep your liner, your lip gloss. And then we also sell oil-absorbing little tissues, and you're going to want to have some extra powder.
So that's why Gina's the best right over there. She's got the good tips here with the makeup. Any other last-minute thoughts, Brendine?
Band-Aids, because people get cut constantly.
Yeah.
And hydrochrome peroxide, because that actually helps with stains as well. And it's really, really nice. It helps amazingly. And bobby pins, definitely. Yeah.
And double stick tape.
Oh, double stick tape, yeah.
Yes.
Very good. Another thing, night before your wedding, get a lot of rest. Lots of rest. Force yourself to get lots of rest. Then, on the morning of your wedding day, eat a very satisfying breakfast. That's something I didn't do on my wedding day, and I really wish I did. Here's a cool idea. For your bridal bouquet, consider creating a lasting bouquet that is kind of like an heirloom, which includes things like silk flowers, ribbons, music sheets, strips of music sheets for your favorite song, feathers, jewelry, vintage bouquets made out of everything from family heirlooms to thrift store treasures. Are definitely repurposed, recycled, and permanent keepsakes to both carry on your wedding day and then later pass on to friends, family, or children. This is a very fun tip. If you're having a flower girl or a ring bearer as part of your wedding ceremony, They tend to be a little antsy during the wedding ceremony. Tape a silver dollar on the place where they need to stand for the wedding ceremony. Tell them that they need to stand on that silver dollar for the whole wedding ceremony, and if they do, they get to keep that silver dollar. So it'll help them know where to stand, it'll give them focus, and give them a little reward, too. So, unless your wedding ceremony has permanently placed rows of seating, you could definitely get creative with this. You could dream up any seating figuration you want. One option is to have the ceremony in the center, and then have chairs all the way around in a circle. When using a unity candle, or other candles at the wedding, light them first, before the wedding ceremony, because a used wick is a lot easier to light than a brand new wick. So that'll make things a lot easier come the ceremony. Any other tips for the ceremony that, ladies, that you can think of off the top of your head? Putting them on the spot.
It's really convenient, and it saves a lot of money if the month of your wedding, you get flowers that are in season month.
Very
and
good.
It really saves tons of money, because if you go to a direct flower export, you can look at different types of flowers, It's really amazing, and it saves tons of money.
Sounds good.
One of the trends that I've been seeing lately is that some of the brides are asking their guests, it's called an unplugged wedding, which means that they drop their cameras and their cell phones, and they do not bring them into the ceremony so that they can actually sit and enjoy the ceremony, because when you are so focused on trying to take pictures, you are not present.
Right.
You completely disconnect, which that's why I'm there, is so that you can just sit there and enjoy the moment and let the photographer capture those moments, because you'll get to see them, you'll get to have some, I promise, but just to actually enjoy the wedding. So don't bring your camera, don't bring in your cell phone, and just enjoy it.
That's great advice. I did a wedding ceremony a long time ago, and I was doing the music for the wedding ceremony, and my phone went off, and had a very fun little jingle, and I was right up in front, everyone heard it. Needless to say, that was the last time that I brought my cell phone to a wedding ceremony. We're going to move on to the wedding reception. To add a special touch to your dinner during a wedding reception, have waiters offer freshly grated cheese or ground pepper. That's a nice added touch. Or you can offer a espresso or a cappuccino bar. Before a dinner at your reception, don't forget to propose a special toast to your parents. This is a memory that a lot of people are very glad that they did. And I've had brides tell me that they wish they would have done that. So I always give that as advice. If you're having a wedding in a colder month, giving guests hot chocolate as a wedding favor or serving it to them, that's very fun. Be very careful with using tea lights and candles in general. I've done a few events where the tea lights actually cracked and shattered the mirrors that they were on because of the heat. I also did a wedding where the bread basket was lined with a cloth napkin, and it went up in flames from one of the lights on the table. Definitely be careful with the tea lights and the candles.
We're eliminating all those great wedding memories.
Yeah. The things you talk about for years.
They have electric tea lights now.
Yes,
thank
they do.
Goodness they had electric tea lights at one of my bride's weddings, because she had lined the aisle with little bags with tea lights in them.
Yeah.
And as her dress went down, so did all of the little bags. So thankfully, they were electric.
Wow.
Because that would have been bad.
Oh, yeah. Definitely. At your gift table, put out some recipe cards along with a recipe box, and put a little sign on it that asks the guests to write out their recipe for a successful marriage. So love tips. Some of the guests were doing love tips. Some of the guests were doing actual recipes. Arrange a very, very fun children's area. Something that looks very creative, gorgeous, very fun, that entertains them and enables the adults to relax during signage has become a huge hit at weddings. I've seen menus written in chalk, removable wall art featuring the couple's joint monogram. The ring bearer hold a sign, like a pennant sign. That was very fun. At the end of the ceremony or reception, instead of throwing rice or using bubbles, a fun alternative is sparklers. Give your guests sparklers. Know that some tuxedo shops and venues have an agreement where you can leave the groomsmen tuxedos at the venue to be picked up by the tuxedo shop.
Yeah, if you don't do that, also just designate one person to bring them all back, one person after the wedding to collect all the pieces, and then everybody doesn't have to worry about, oh, where's that bow tie, where's that piece of jewelry, and getting them all back.
For a smoother flow of the guests during the reception, make sure not to set up any bars or buffets or anything right at the entrance. I've seen that done, and then you create kind of a traffic jam right at the beginning. So those are good to set up towards the end of the room. If you're doing a buffet table, make sure to have both sides of the buffet accessible as opposed to setting it up against the wall so people can move through that very quickly. If you're looking to save money for an outdoor wedding on a tent rental, ask your local car dealership if you can rent one of their tents. A lot of them will do that simply for mentioning their car dealership in your wedding programs. So it's a way for you to advertise them, get a free tent or a discounted tent, your wedding cake at your wedding reception. Offering only cake for dessert is definitely a thing of the past now. The latest fad is what I call cake pops on a stick. Sometimes they call them donut pops. There's a lot of bakeries out here that do those. I've also seen them at a lot of coffee shops, too. My wife loves the cake pops. For your wedding cake, adding fresh flowers on the cake for an extra added touch is very, very nice. And then also ask your, let your bakery know that's doing your wedding cake, your desserts, as much information as you can about the temperature in the room. I've seen a wedding cake outdoors start leaning quite a bit. And it was middle of the cocktail hour, and I went up to the photographer, and I said, you know, we need to do the cake cutting right now. And she's like, no, it's not time for the cake cutting. And so, yeah, we need to do it right now. And I said, look at the cake. She was like, okay, let's do it right now. Consider making edible centerpieces, flower-shaped cookies on a stick in a decorated flower pot. Many brides and grooms are adding what's called a groom's cake. A cake designed specifically for the groom. For instance, if you're having a wedding and your groom is a fireman, you can have a fire engine designed cake. And then I've seen the bride and groom use a fireman's axe to cut the cake. So you can get very creative with that. For the videographer, if you're having a wedding videographer, which is very, very important, to show for children when they grow up, family members, friends that unfortunately had to miss the wedding. What I was told is a really good idea is to hold with you a few words of appreciation for people at your wedding party. Because what I found is that sometimes the videographer will start shooting, point at you, and they'll be at a loss for words. They'll not know what to say. Nowadays, newlyweds are getting very, very creative with their modes of exit. I've seen an old-fashioned horse and carriage drive them off from the wedding reception. I've seen others ride off on a bicycle built for two. I heard of one couple that actually floated out on a boat. They were next to water, so they actually floated out on a boat. That was very nice. Very good video, very good pictures. While you're on the honeymoon, tell everybody at the honeymoon that you're on the honeymoon. For instance, like restaurants, say, hey, we just got married, we're on our honeymoon. You won't believe how many restaurants have gifts ready for newlywed couples. From a free meal to a free bottle of champagne, free dessert, that's a great tip. Last tip, when it's all said and done, remember that some flaws and mistakes are inevitable. Don't sweat it. Most people usually don't even notice. The main focus is that you and your groom got married. You guys are about to start a wonderful life together. And definitely good luck on your wedding. If you have any other questions, any of us up here can help you out, answer any more questions after the wedding show here. My name is DJ Scott Fajolik. Again, we have Lenan White from American Rose Bridal. Let's give Lenan a round of applause for being with us today. A big thank you to Elaine Turso and Elaine Turso Photography. And the wonderful Gina Teresi from Mary Kay. And last but definitely not least, Brandine Baumgartner with Diligent Details. Thank you very much.
Thank you, DJ Scott. Let's give him a round of applause. Thank you. There are so many details to be mindful of with a wedding, are there not?